most exciting hours. Already in action in the ring. Six-man tag team action. In one corner, you've got Dory Funk Jr., Rufus R. Freight Train Jones, and the ever-moving, ever-on-the-go, you never know what he's going to do, Jimmy Valiant, all in one corner. Across the ring, Bill White, Ben Alexander, Tony Russo. The match already in progress, and it is Bill White in at the moment with Dory Funk Jr. And White, since the opening moments of the match, which began just a couple of minutes ago, White has had an arm of Funk, and they've had Funk in the ring, unable to make a tag since the bell began. Also, during this hour, you'll see a match for the Mid-Atlantic Championship with a 30-minute time limit. Ivan Koloff, the champion, against Angelo Mosca Jr. Last week, those two right here on Mid-Atlantic. Them all on. Now Valiant slamming White to the corner of the ropes, off to the elbow. Here's the freight train. He's got that freight train going, and down goes White, who makes a tag for Russo. Tony Russo down. Rufus right on top of him, waiting for him to get up, slams him to the ropes. Train again. He's got him set. There's the headbutt. Here comes Funk in. Hooks the leg. Covers him with a press. One, two, three. Fans watching slow motion. Just a portion of it right here. Good to see you, and I tell you, if we can hear you above the roar of this great crowd, Angelo.
Fantastic, fantastic crowd.
I know you're going to be looking forward to this upcoming match for this championship.
I sure am. First of all, I want to say that my son has probably never been more mentally, physically, they say he's young, inexperienced. I don't agree, because attitude will overcome anything at all. And I want to show you why. I think my son's got one heck of a chance, because he has developed an attitude in the last few days.
All right, and we've got, I think, a piece of tape which shows him being hit by Koloff, right?
You better believe it, because not only was my son hit, I was knocked down too. If the man can't accept how tough the kid is, that's too bad. I just want you to see this.
That's from your fans, right. From the people out there.
I just want to thank all the people. I'm just, you know, 1983 is a great year, and
Listen, you young punk, I give you one chance, and that's the only chance you're going to get at Mid-Atlantic title. You couldn't be caught up, and that's all there's to it.
Listen, Dave, don't...
Oh, he hit you, then he grabbed that plaque, and he hit your son right in the top of the head. With it after a
I've been telling my son all week, in professional wrestling, you have to develop an attitude. He's always had a winner's attitude. But that's the time you got to reach down and dig and get a little bit more. Ivan Koloff is in for a battle of his life today.
All right, fans, it's for the Mid-Atlantic Championship, a 30-minute time limit. Fans, this match for the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship. First, the challenger from Boston, 230 pounds. It's young Angelo Mosca Jr., the champion, the Russian Bear from Russia. The Mid-Atlantic champion, 245 pounds, the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff. One fall, a 30-minute time. There's the Bear with his manager in there, Gary Hart, helping him off with his cape. And there you see the championship belt that goes with that Mid-Atlantic Championship. And last week, fans, if you were here with us and saw Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling, you saw a tremendous match for a 10-minute time limit where this youngster, Angelo Mosca Jr., carried Ivan Koloff right to the limit and then some.
It's not the point that my son couldn't beat Ivan Koloff. Ivan Koloff could not beat my son.
Here is Junior back to the ropes. Koloff right away goes with a big right hand. He's trying to take him out in a hurry, Angelo. Fans, let me remind you right here again, this match for a 30-minute time limit, and we will have a TV timeout if the match goes that long. The bell will sound, the match will be halted for a TV timeout due to commitments that we have. You will not miss a single moment of action during this match. Let me just tell you that again and reiterate it. You will not miss one single moment of the action, even though we take a TV timeout.
My son realizes that he has his hands full. But Koloff just created a monster last week. Now he knows that he has his hands full.
All right, they're out near the center of the ring, and young Angelo Mosca Jr. with a headlock on Koloff. And Koloff, it seems to really bother Koloff when he gets him in that headlock. I think he puts so much pressure on him. Angelo.
All right!
And, of course, the big one rooting for him in the background is the daddy, Angelo Mosca, right here with us, who is really rooting on his son. And he's making a tremendous showing so far, Angelo.
I'm sweating so hard here. When you see your own flesh and blood, you realize things that you might do. But I'll tell you what, my son has come a million miles, and this is an opportunity of a lifetime. Koloff is one great wrestler, world-renowned, one tough individual. I've been wrestling him, too. But I have been schooling my son all week long and telling him the do's and the don'ts with Koloff. And I hope that he has heeded every warning I've told him.
With that arm again, he rolls him right around the ring. Still now, with the arm in his rolling the bear right around that ring, Angelo. Keeping the pressure on the Russian bear, who is the champion.
When he's working on a point of a man where he's weakening him down, keep on working on that point, and that's how you become victorious.
Fans, again, remember, we will be taking a TV timeout during this match. The bell will sound. The match will be halted. You will not miss a single moment of action during this match. The match for a 30-minute time limit. Also, let me remind you, a little later in the program, you'll be seeing the first of our quarterfinal matches in our NWA Television Championship Tournament. Mark Youngblood against Barry Orton. That match right here coming up later in the program. Greg Valentine was scheduled to wrestle the Big Cat Ernie Ladd, but due to a schedule conflict, Valentine could not be here. That match will definitely be right here next week on Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling.
You know, Bob, this is everybody, every mother and father out there that goes to a football game, goes to a basketball game and sees his son. But now he's in one-on-one confrontation. See, Koloff being a foxy man that he is, he wants to retain that belt. He's going to do anything at all costs.
Well, he got a knee up to the side of the head, and there's an elbow. Boy, and I tell you, he's got a lot of punch and a lot of power in the elbow.
Well, just take a look. Ivan is one great physical specimen of a professional wrestler. If my son is lucky to ever attain a victory over him, he's got one of the world-renowned wrestlers in Ivan Koloff.
All right, he had a count of two right there on young Angelo Mosca Jr. Koloff with the front face. And a man outside of the ring, and fans, you got to look at him pacing. There you see him pacing again, up and down outside of that ring, and Gary Hart. And Gary Hart doesn't seem to be any too confident at this point.
Well, every time that you step in the ring, anything can happen on any given day, just like a football team or a basketball team. Anybody can be beaten on any given day. And I think Ivan Koloff realizes that he has his hands full.
All right, here's the bear now. There goes Junior right through the ropes, off of the apron, down hard on the floor, as Koloff just swung him right out of the ring.
But that's what you call when a man is beating you down to your point. To get a breather, you throw the man out so that you can gather your wits. Because Ivan knows that he's in trouble.
Angelo Mosca Jr. now, he got hurt when he hit that floor coming out of that ring and when he hit on that apron. Now moving that arm, and I think he took a blow right to the chest, Angelo, when he came flying through the rope.
I told him what professional wrestling is all about in this Mid-Atlantic area. It's got some of the greatest wrestlers in the world today. You've got to take the bumps and the bruises. And if you want to take a day off, you can't afford to, because every time you look over your shoulder, somebody's gaining on you. And I told him, you want to be the best, you got to play with Hurts and wrestle with Hurts.
All right, we're going to hike right here, fans. As the referee now is talking to him, we're going to take our TV timeout. We'll be right back. All right, fans, we're back and ready to go back with action again. And Koloff comes charging out. There's the bell, and here they go at it. Ivan Koloff came charging.
If it cost $50 for a ringside ticket, I would pay $50 to see this match.
It's been a tremendous match. Action from the word go, Angelo, since the opening bell. These two have gone at it tooth and nail. Neither one of them is going to give an inch. And Koloff now appears to be coming on a little strong right here now. It looks like he may have gotten a second win. And he looks more determined than ever.
My son's got a second win right here.
Here's the bear. Angelo Mosca Jr. up with a backbreaker. And that's a tough blow right there, Angelo.
Come on, Edge!
Koloff now. He's just got those claws dug into the side, into the back. Tremendous strength in those hands.
Koloff knows the science of professional wrestling. When he's got a man hurt, he knows what area to go through. He gave him the backbreaker, and he went right to that rib cage.
He has tremendous strength and power, Angelo, in those hands.
Just take a look at the body on Ivan Koloff. 250 pounds of solid muscle.
Fans, remember this match for the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship. The champion, Ivan Koloff. The challenger, Angelo Mosca Jr. Speaking of champions, also during this hour, you'll see the U.S. heavyweight champ, Dick Slater, in action right here. Koloff continuing now to put that pressure to the side into the rib cage.
I just hope he's reaching down. He's got a little extra. It's just like the fourth quarter in football.
You can tell that Junior was in tremendous pain, but he came back and got that foot.
Come on, Ash! Come on, gentlemen!
Trying now to turn him over. Oh, a count of one. Count of two that time. Here comes the bear up. Gets the fingers into the eyes.
Koloff realizes he's got his handful. He's resorting to all tactics.
Comes with that knee again, right to the side of the head. Brings Angelo Mosca Jr. out. Looked like he was trying to set him up for a pile driver. Well, he couldn't go with a pile driver. Instead, he came with that blow, the big blow to the back of the neck.
Come on, Edge!
Forearm again. He's got Junior now staggering around the ring.
Come on!
Angelo Mosca Jr. winning the most tremendous blows from Ivan Koloff. Down goes Koloff from the right hand. The leg hook. He's got him covered, a count of two again. Ever so close,
I can't stand this. I'm sweating so much, I feel like that I'm in the ring.
He was very, very close right there. Head scissors now by the bear.
Some great wrestling hosts, some great skill have been provided for the people of wrestling and the TV audience and all the shut-ins.
It's been a great match, packed with nothing but action. Action and excitement as these two first one and then the other. Now, still with the head scissors, here's Angelo Mosca Jr. Jumps out of it. He was going to go with the arm drag, and Ivan Koloff with a good counter.
That's what I mean. Ivan knows every counter to everything there is. He's resorting to all methods to try to retain that belt.
He started clawing and ripping at the eyes again. Now from behind, he attacks. The Russian is pulling out all the stops. Bear hug.
Come on, Ed, fight it!
Koloff with a bear hug on Angelo Mosca Jr. This man has such...
Great power in those shoulders and those arms. Bob, this is a tough match because of all these hot TV lights. I just hope my son has got something left.
Angelo, right here, this hole will really take it out of you, this bear hug.
It just
drains every bit of your strength.
They put that head right in that solar plexus, and they just squeeze that air right off.
Again, the Russian applying the pressure, squeezing it ever tighter now, right around the midsection. Going to the head and the forehead. Mosca Jr. trying everything he can think of at the moment now to break this bear hug.
Down he goes!
When he went after Koloff again, he ran to the knee. Always looking and always on the alert is the Russian bear, Ivan Koloff, one of the great ones.
This has to be a main event at any arena in the United States or Canada.
Koloff now lifts him up. Over he goes with a backflip.
And as you say, they have both been going at it. They're both beat down. They've both taken a tremendous amount of punishment.
But that's right.
Oscar Jr. going back to get that drop kick, and boy, that took something. He reached down to get a lot of reserve for that. Now with a foot again, gonna drag Koloff near the center of the ring. Gotta go with a toehold. Yeah, he's got the Russian in trouble. Koloff reaching and straining, trying to get to the ropes.
He's trying all sorts to save himself now, because Koloff knows he's in trouble. But he's a cunning and witting man. I know he'll probably figure out something.
All right, now with the other foot. Here's Junior again. Now he's got. Oh, he's going to go with that spinning toe.
Corrales!
He's got it locked in now, and Ivan Koloff. Very painful hold right here.
That's one of the toughest holds in professional wrestling. You can break a man's leg just with one wrong turn.
Now Koloff turning down, reaches back, grabs the ropes. You see Gary Hart just saying, come on, pull to the ropes, get to the ropes.
Referee
Schwartz breaks it up. Koloff really in some pain on that leg, though. Watch him staggering around on it. Down he goes. Again, Junior went for the leg. He's going to bring it out near the center of the ring. Goes to work, continues to work to the leg. He may have gotten a little careless right there, Angelo.
On this match,
30-minute time limit.
30 minutes.
I don't see how two men could go at this pace
this
for 30 minutes.
This is proving a conditioning factor of what professional wrestlers are made of.
It's been this pace since the opening bell, Angelo. They both had to be in tremendous condition to even last this far in this. Junior picks up Koloff, slams him hard to the mat. He's going to go to the ropes. In the corner now on the top rope. Dives on Koloff. One, two, three. Over the ropes, he pinned him. Angelo Mosca goes charging toward the ring. Referee Stu Swartz raising the hand now of Angelo Mosca Jr., the new Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion, and there's that championship belt. Gary Hart can't believe it. Neither can Ivan Koloff. Two extremely happy people right there in that corner. Angelo Mosca Sr., Angelo Mosca Jr., the new Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion, having defeated the Russian Bear right here before an overflow crowd. Tremendous match from the opening bell all the way to the finish. And we'll be back right after this. All right, fans, you're looking right there at the bell at the United States Heavyweight Champion Dick Slater. And you saw that championship belt around the waist. Slater has got his hands full of flyers. And those, I'm sure I have not seen it. I saw one of them last week. I am positive that it's the flyer that proclaims Dick Slater not only the U.S. heavyweight champion, but also the world champion. And Dick Slater at the moment is the only one making that claim that he's the world champion. NWA world heavyweight champion is still Ric Flair, recognized by the NWA and recognized by almost everyone else with the exception of Dick Slater. Slater in action here against John Bonello. And at the opening bell, it's Bonello who was down on the mat as Slater went with the arm drag. Bonello over the ropes with a good block, and that time ran headlong right into the elbow. Bonello came off of the ropes once, got away with that block, second time. No go as Slater was ready with the elbow. Headbutt now, and Bonello again to the mat. This man right here, a whale of an athlete, fans, Dick Slater. You may not like him. You may not like the way he wrestles. And you just may not like his personality or the man himself. But he's a whale of an athlete and a great professional wrestler. He's rugged. He's rough. He's tough. He's mean. He's anything that a professional wrestler and a great one should be. And Slater is that. Well-conditioned, tremendous athlete. Very strong, rugged individual. Now he's got Bonello with that inside grapevine. Takedown. Elbow smash now. Hard to the chest. He just rolls back now at this point. Looks at Bonello, who's flat down on the mat. Sets Bonello up now for the elbow smash to the top of the head. And Bonello has been in trouble just about since the opening bell. Way high to the air with a back toss. Long way to come down as Slater had him about 7 feet high to the air. That suplex. Now he's going to cover him with a press, and he comes right off at a count of one. Slater not ready to pin him. He says, hold it, Mr. Referee. Wait just a minute. I'm not ready for this. Reaches down, gets Bonello now by the hair. He's going to hold him high to the air, and another suplex. Now he rolls right on through it again. Again he refuses to pin him. Twice now, Dick Slater could have pinned John Bonello out of the suplex. Each time he's refused to pin him. Wants to punish him, wants to hurt him a little more. Bonello defenseless out near the center of the ring, flat on the mat. Now Slater's got him covered, only for a moment again, and quickly up again he comes. I tell you, the referee is going to get a little more than perturbed at Dick Slater here. And Slater better watch it. He can let Bonello come back, and it can cost him. Another suplex as Bonello is lifted again, high to the air by Slater. One, two, three. Well, on the third go-round, Dick Slater pinned him after three suplexes. On the first two, he just came right off, refused to cover him, refused to pin him. Our winner, U.S. champ, Dick Slater, and we'll be back. As we say, Dick Slater, our winner right there, Paul Jones and the Assassins. Paul?
You know, I've been telling people that I wanted Jimmy Valiant to sign a contract to wrestle by Assassins. And you know something, let me tell you, the reason we're so happy is yours, the contract. You know, I've been telling people how dumb and stupid and ignorant Valiant is, and this proves it. Valiant, I didn't think you, deep down inside, I didn't think you were that stupid. But here it is, Valiant. Now, I want to ask you promoters to do me a favor. I want this match, Valiant, to get anybody who wants Dory Funk right here on TV, whether it's this week, next week, the week after that. But I got the match right here, and I want to ask you promoters to do me one favor. Don't take Valiant's side and make excuses for Valiant. If Valiant just say, no, I changed my mind, I got a headache, don't let them. Don't show any favoritism. I don't need favoritism towards my Assassins. So don't show it to Valiant. He signed a contract. Make him show up.
Paul, that match will be right here on television. And it won't be too long. It'll be right here for all the fans.
We're so happy. I love all of you.
Mwah! Fans, we'll be back right after this timeout. All right, fans, right here, U.S. champ Dick Slater, one half of the World Tag Team Champions, Don Kernodle.
If you want to keep your job, you'll call me the pride of the Carolinas, because that's exactly what I am. It's not easy traveling all over the world being the world champion, but I do it. And I come back to my home, North Carolina, to wrestle, and where are all the great tag teams at? Where's Wahoo McDaniels? Where is everybody? Where's Steamboat? Steamboat retired because when I won these belts. Youngblood, where's Youngblood? Where are all the great tag teams at? I go all over the world defending this belt. And believe me, it's not easy to be a winner. It's not easy to be a world champion. It's not even easy for the pride of the Carolinas. All you people out there that's never done anything right before in your life, has never held a championship of any kind, you don't know what I'm talking about. Bob Orton Jr. got so mad he left the building. We came here to wrestle and our opponents wouldn't show up. There's no competition around here. We thrive on competition, and let me tell you something right now. We're going all over the world, and we're going to defeat everybody. Everybody's going to suffer pain, agony, and defeat with Orton and Kernodle.
Right here, U.S. champ Dick Slater. Dick, I saw you throwing those flyers around.
I got something very important on my mind. And now I'm on a mission. If there's one thing I can't stand, it's Ric Flair going around this country and around this world wearing the United States, wearing the world's heavyweight championship belt around his waist. You know, when a man claims to be world's heavyweight champion, like Ric Flair is claiming to be, the only thing is missing is Flair. You're wearing my title around your waist, and I'll keep on showing these people time after time after time. Run it again. Run it again. I want to show you where I became the world's heavyweight champion. Right now, run it.
There it is, right here, Dick.
But you can see this right there. That referee, one, two, three.
Who is that holding
Dick
the
Dick Slater is the new world's heavyweight champion. I'm going to be the United States heavyweight champion. Now, Ric Flair, the only thing I want you to do is walk yourself right back in this area and hand over that title belt, because when you come back in here, not only do I have something for you, I'll give you another title shot, but I'm going to slap your face till you can't stand it, my friend, because if any man makes me sick going around claiming to be the world's heavyweight champion, it's Ric Flair. Right here is a true champion. I am representing
right,
this world.
That's it, right
I am
here,
the world's heavyweight champion.
Right
right
after.
You know, Slater, for you to come out here on a nationally televised wrestling program and announce to the world not only that you put my shoulders down for a count of three, but that you claim to be the new world's heavyweight champion is probably the greatest insult ever for Ric Flair, the greatest insult ever in the history of the National Wrestling Alliance. You see, Slater, the way guys get to be world champion is by walking that road and beating all the top contenders, and then they get in the ring with a champion all by themselves, and they score a pinfall, or they beat the man with a submission. Now, you know, Slater, and I know, and I don't care what you try and bogus off to Bob Connell or David Crockett, these wrestling fans all throughout the world know that there's one world heavyweight champion, there's one man right now that's paid the price and gone a little further than anybody else, and that's Ric Flair. And no matter what you or Orton Jr. or anybody else try to tell the wrestling world, Ric Flair is the world champion, and the only way we're going to settle our problems, Slater, is when you and I get back in the ring together, Daddy. Woo!
Fans, we're ready now with our first quarterfinal match in our NWA Television Championship Tournament. Our opponents in this match, first, 230 pounds from Texas, Mark Youngblood. Young Mark Youngblood. His opponent, 220 pounds, Las Vegas, Nevada, Barry Orton. Barry Orton, one fall, fans, with a 15-minute time limit to bell, and we're ready now with action. Young Mark Youngblood, Barry Orton. Youngblood, who has just developed exceedingly fast in recent months after arriving on Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling. He got in with some real seasoned veterans, guys like Wahoo McDaniel and, of course, his brother Jay Youngblood and Rick Steamboat. Orton missed that elbow drop. Here's Youngblood with the arm drag. Takedown again. Good quick speed on both men's part. Boy, you got a lot of speed there, like grease lightning in the ring. Youngblood, who developed and learned a lot in just a few quick months, really, really shows a great improvement in the ring. Moving, turning, twisting, sitting out. Orton can't hold him as Orton falls back to the ropes. Our winner in this match, of course, will advance to one of our semifinal matches. And fans, let me remind you, next week right here, another quarterfinal match, and that match will feature Greg Valentine against the Big Cat Ernie Ladd. Ernie Ladd, Greg Valentine right here in another quarterfinal match next week on Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling. Youngblood has a hit scissors. Now Orton turns into him. Going to try to get enough of force and leverage here to pull out of that, but still into that head. He's got the legs now. There's the head free. Dives up for the headlock. Back to the head scissors. Youngblood got him back into position very quickly to put that head scissor back on, and he's got it on tight. Again, Orton's going to turn in. Again, going to try to pull out of it. Youngblood's training. He's putting everything he can into that leg scissors, trying to hold that head. Again, he jumps out, this time now with a wrist. Orton holding onto the wrist, had the shoulders to the mat for the count of one. Now here's Youngblood quickly on his feet again, refusing to stay on the mat. These two are moving like cats. Good, quick action in this match. As they're on their feet, Youngblood goes down again, and Orton got a handful of hair. Fans, we also have a match scheduled to follow this one, the Assassins 1 and 2 against Gene Ligon and Michael Sam Houston. Tag team action to follow. Here's Youngblood on the mat again. Again, Orton now with the arm. Orton has had that arm since it came out of the head scissors, and he's been making Youngblood work and work hard. It's taking all of his strength and energy just to keep from getting pinned and to keep the shoulders off of the mat. Orton up on his toes now, getting leverage on that arm bar. Still with the arm, still with the pressure is Barry Orton. Again up on the toes. Youngblood backs him now toward the ropes. Swings him off of the ropes. Over comes Orton. Crisscross. Orton caught him in the center of the ring for the backbreaker. Count of two. Mark Youngblood kicks out. He came ever so close to being pinned right there. Orton almost had him. Good hard blow to the side of the head. Trying to set him up again now to get him in a position for a suplex. Out of the air. And goes Youngblood from the suplex. Orton's got him covered again. Two, and again he kicks out. Almost pinned for the second time. Mark Youngblood. Remember, the winner of this match will advance. Youngblood's got him stacked up in the package. Two that time on Orton. Our winner will advance to one of the semifinal matches. Here's Youngblood. Over the ropes with a hard right hand. Boy, that sends him flying and reeling backwards. All the way across the ring goes Orton from the tremendous power in that right hand. Tomahawk chop. Now on the attack is Mark Youngblood. Chop right to the midsection as Orton comes out of the ropes. A foot across the ropes. Youngblood went for a pin. Barry Orton put a foot right across the bottom rope to stop the action. And Youngblood right back on the attack again. Whips him to the ropes. Catches him coming off. High to the air. Power slam. Again a count of two. And again Orton kicks out at the count of two. Almost had Youngblood pinned. A good reversal on the part of Orton. It's been reversal upon reversal. Each time a count of two, and Orton again made the ropes for about the third time. He's been close enough to get a foot on the rope. Clothesline as Youngblood comes charging off of the ropes. Almost three. The referee had the hand in the air for the third count. Now it's Youngblood in the ropes. Barry Orton reaches down, grabs the wrist and a hand, whips him toward the rope. Youngblood back from the right hand. Three. And a great win for the youngster Mark Youngblood over Barry Orton. Youngblood coming back and coming back strong. Pins Barry Orton to advance to the semifinals. The winner of our first quarterfinal match in our NWA Television Championship Tournament. Watch right here as Orton is ready to go in slow motion. And Youngblood ducked right under this blow, the beginning of the end for Barry Orton with our winner, Mark Youngblood. And we'll be back.
The world is full of kings and queens. I am the bleach blonde with star-spangled eyes that was chosen to come to war in this last decade. Because on the street, they know my name. In the gutters of New York City, in North Carolina, in Florida, throughout the world, the winos know my name. And now the assassins will know my name and Paul Jones, because the star-spangled eyes that glitter in the night is now prepared with my brother for war and making it street legal.
Hi, fans at the Bell. You're looking at the Assassins and Paul Jones. Their manager will watch the Assassins in a tag team match as they go against Gene Ligon and Michael Sam Houston. It will be Ligon now as the match gets underway against the Assassin. Let me remind you, already during this hour, fans, you have seen a new Mid-Atlantic champion crowned in a whale of a match. The youngster Angelo Mosca Jr. defeating the champion Ivan Koloff right here on television to win that Mid-Atlantic championship belt. Also, you have seen one winner now in our quarterfinal matches for our NWA television tournament championship. And that was Mark Youngblood as he defeated Barry Orton in our match preceding this one. So we've had a great hour, tremendous action for you, and plenty more to come right here with the Assassins in the ring. Also, let's remind you about Paul Jones and the Assassins, which took up the challenge of Jimmy Valiant. And let me remind you, fans, as soon as the scheduling arrangements can be made, as soon as all the contracts can be signed and it all can be worked out, and the travel and everything else worked out, it's all figured, then that match will be definitely right here on Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling. The match with the Assassins and Jimmy Valiant, whoever Valiant will choose as a partner. We'll have it for you in the coming weeks right here. The Assassins have changed. They have switched now. Ligon reaches back and makes a tag to Sam Houston. Houston, who's a tall, lanky youngster. And this Assassin, who is a very heavy, rugged, strong, powerful individual. The heavier of the two, but both of these Assassins are extremely strong individuals. They're both heavy. They're both big men, very powerful guys. Good hard forearm blow right to the side of the head. Houston is back to the ropes. The Assassin right back on the attack. Slings him into the corner, right into the knee from the Assassin outside the ring. And they're going to change and switch again. The Assassin in there right now has got muscles on muscles. As Houston comes off of the ropes to the knee to the midsection. Fans, let me remind you also, next week, right here on Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling, our next quarterfinal match for our NWA television tournament, it will be Greg Valentine against the big cat Ernie Ladd. That match right here next week. Here's Houston slammed to the knee in the corner. The Assassins now make the tag. They'll switch again. They do a lot of switching and a lot of changing. They work very well as a tag team. Houston now back to the ropes, slung to the ropes, off and over the Assassin. As the Assassin leaps right over the head, and Houston caught a knee to the back. Picked up and slammed hard with a power slam, driven almost through the mat. The Assassin caught the ropes. And Houston is going to be pinned. Off of the ropes with all of the weight off of that top rope. No way that Houston was going to be able to get up from that. A tremendous blow with the winners, the Assassins. Let's bring in these two happy ones right here. Of course, first, let's congratulate this young man, the new Mid-Atlantic champ, Angelo Mosca Jr. What a match, Angelo.
It was a very, very tough match, but you know something? I got a lot of respect for Ivan Koloff. I'll never lose that respect. The man is tough, but I was able to do it, and I came up with the belt, and I have never been happier in my life than right now.
I tell you, you proved in there that you can go with the best. You had it all going for you, and you just kept taking it to him.
The people were really with me, and you know something? When those people are with you, you really feel it in here. And you know something? Without that in here, I don't think I could have ever done it without those people.
I don't think I've ever seen a happier dad than this man right here.
You know, and every day there's always a proud moment in a parent's life.
And I can talk as a parent on professional wrestling. And right at the moment, I'm so elated, I'm stuck for words. Not too often am I ever stuck for words. But today was my son's day. And just remember, Ivan Koloff, Gary Hart, I made a statement once before that blood is thicker than water.
Angelo, I know you're proud. Congratulations again, Angelo Mosca Jr., right here. Chief Wahoo McDaniel Wahoo, and this youngster right here, Mark Youngblood. And Mark, you advance right on to a semifinal match and a tremendous win for you over Barry Orton.
Thank you. You know, Barry Orton's a tough competitor, you know. Come to the Mid-Atlantic area for a few things, and that's to win, Bill. You know, that's my main goal, is get to the top. I love it when that referee says, you're the winner. It makes me feel good inside. And, you know, none of this could be possible if it wasn't for one Mr. Chief Wahoo McDaniel, you know. He's responsible for the actions in the ring. He's shown me everything that's going on. He shows me to do right and to do wrong. I'm just going to have to thank Chief for supporting me, for showing me how to do what I have to do.
Chief, I tell you, he's a great learner. He learned quick, too.
Well, let me tell you something. You know, he's being a little modest. You know, the man, you can look at him. He's 6'2", 240, 50 pounds here. And it's like I told him, I said, the only thing you like is just that little bit of mean streak. And he said, well, he was a little timid because he didn't want people to dislike him. But let me tell you, the people like a winner, and that's what he is, and that's why I took the time and the effort. And he's got a lot of ability, and I'm going to take a pick right here, brother. He's got as good a chance of winning that TV title as anybody in wrestling, and I'm going to keep continuing to train him, and I guarantee you when he gets in the ring, they're going to see things that they won't know where he got it from.
You're talking about continuing to go. You know, it's really the matches that get tougher and tougher and tougher when you get into the semifinals and the final.
That's right, bro. You know, you have Dick Slater, you have Orton Jr., you have Don Canoodle. They're all tough, but I tell you what, I'm here to stay, and I'm here to beat people. Thank you very much, Bill.
Fans, that'll do it for this week, and we'll see you next week. Until then, so long for now.